Good morning, children. Children, today we are going to learn in chapter redox reaction, Daniell cell, standard electrode potential, different terminologies involved in Daniell cell, and significance of standard electrode potential value for any redox couple. Let's start. Now children, consider this reaction. In this reaction, what is happening? This is a redox reaction where one zinc metal is losing electron, turning up into zinc ion, and copper ion is accepting electron to turn up into copper metal. If you recall your standard 10, you have learned displacement reaction. Displacement reaction is the one where the more reactive metal used to displace less reactive metal from its salt solution to make its own. And if you remember, in your class 10, you have taken copper sulfate solution and you put one zinc rod into it, and redox reaction start taking place, which is also called displacement reaction. After some time, you observe that the blue color solution, which is of copper sulfate solution, start disappearing its color, and it is gradually turning up into the colorless solution because the zinc sulfate solution is forming. We can say here, when you are adding zinc rod there, zinc will start losing electron, and those two electrons which is coming from the zinc metal will be accepted by the copper ion to turn up into isolated copper metal or copper metal, which used to settle down in the beaker. In that case, what is happening? There is a direct transfer of electron from zinc atom to cupric ion. The electron transfer from zinc atom to cupric ion can be demonstrated by carrying out two half reactions into two separate containers. And now such reaction which is happening in two separate containers, or I would say two half reactions in two separate containers, we are going to learn that reaction. Let's start with Daniell cell. Now children, this is the setup of Daniell cell. The zinc and copper plates are connected with an electric wire, and it is also connected with a voltmeter and also a switch. The solution in two containers are connected with this salt bridge. Salt bridge, if you are seeing, this is a U-shaped glass rod, and inside that glass rod, the potassium chloride or ammonium nitrate gel is filled. When the electric switch is on, the electric circuit is complete, and there would be a deflection in this voltmeter, and by this deflection we got to know the transference of electron has been started. Now the circuit has two parts, one in the form of electric wire, and this electric wire is allowing the flow of electron, and another connection is through this salt bridge. In the solution part of the circuit, the electric current is carried by the movement of ions. When the circuit is complete, zinc atoms on zinc plates spontaneously start losing electron, and these electrons will be flow from zinc plate to copper plate via this wire, and these electrons will be accepted by cupric ion present in the solution and turn up into copper metal, and that copper metal will start depositing on the copper plate. Here zinc plate act as anode or negative electrode, and copper plate act as cathode or positive electrode. When two half reactions, namely oxidation and reduction, allowed to takes place in the separate container, and the electricity is passing into it, and the electrons are transferring by the external circuit, this kind of cell is simply called as electrochemical cell. The another name of this cell is Daniell cell. The Daniell cell or the electrochemical cell is the cell where the electricity is generated by redox reaction. Children, in electrochemical cell, electrons flow in the external circuit from anode to cathode, while in the conventional current flows, while the conventional current flows from cathode to anode. Children, when the transfer of electron is happening from like one electrode to another electrode, the electrical potential is established at the two electrodes in the electrochemical cell, and this electrical potential is called as electrode potential. That electrode potential has certain magnitude and it has certain direction also. It depends upon the value of electrode potential, it's depending upon the nature of metal and ions, concentration of ions, as well as the temperature also. Children, the reaction involved with any electrode or with any electrode is called as electrode reaction. And the two chemical species which are linked by the transfer of electron is called as redox couple. Like here, zinc is turning up into zinc ion. This is called redox couple. Or this copper ion is turning up into copper metal. It is called as redox couple. Now, the next term is standard electrode potential. Standard electrode potential. Children, when concentration of each species taking part in a redox reaction or in a electrode reaction is unity, I'm talking about the concentration, that means it would be 1 molar and the temperature is 298 Kelvin, then the observed electrode potential is called as standard electrode potential. This standard electrode potential is denoted by E0. By convention, the standard electrode potential of hydrogen electrode is considered as 0.00 volt. Standard electrode potential of hydrogen electrode is used as a reference electrode for determining E0 value for various redox couples also. Now we are going to learn about the significance of standard electrode potential. Significance of standard electrode potential or E0. The electrode reaction considered for the electrode potential is reduction reaction. Therefore, value and sign of electrode standard electrode potential is measured ऑफ द टेंडेंसी ऑफ एक्टिव स्पीशीज इन इलेक्ट्रोड रिएक्शन टू रिमेन ऑक्सीडाइज्ड और इन रिड्यूसिंग फॉर्म. चिल्ड्रन, इजी वर्ड्स आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट नेगेटिव ई नॉट वैल्यू मीन्स हाउ द रिडॉक्स कपल इज स्ट्रॉन्गर रिएजेंट देन द हाइड्रोजन रिडॉक्स कपल. मोर द नेगेटिव वैल्यू ऑफ ई नॉट इज, इट इज इंडिकेटिंग द स्ट्रॉन्गर रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट द रिडॉक्स कपल इज. चिल्ड्रन, द एल्कली मेटल्स हैव ग्रेट टेंडेंसी टू गिव अवे द इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड फॉर्म कैटायन. सो द एल्कली मेटल्स आर स्ट्रॉन्ग रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट, whereas fluorine has the highest tendency to gain electron, which is having the high positive value of E naught. So it is strong oxidizing agent. Children, these many are the redox couples which have the definite E naught values. Children, when question used to come regarding the redox couple involving the E naught value, they used to ask after giving two redox couple, and they used to ask which one is the stronger reducing agent or stronger oxidizing agent. Let's talk about one numerical. So the numerical is, children, by using a standard electrode potential, we need to find out the reaction is spontaneous or not. First, we are going to write half reduction reaction. Then we are going to write another half oxidation reaction along with their E naught values. Children, we all know in reduction reaction, there is an acceptance of electron. So what is happening when ferric ion is transforming into ferrous ion? The electron must have accepted by ferric ion so that it has turned up into ferrous. Similarly, when there is a oxidation reaction, there would be the elimination of electron. So iodide ion is turning up into iodine and the two electrons are released. Because in oxidation reaction two electrons are released, that is why we have taken two ferric plus two electrons give two ferrous ions. Because we have doubled the number, that is why we have to multiply by 2 to the standard electrode potential of this redox couple. We will get value 1.54, and because we have inverted this reaction, that is why we have inverted the sign of this standard electrode potential also. After adding both the electrode potential, if you are getting positive value, that means the reaction is spontaneous. This is how the spontaneity of any reaction could be predicted with the help of standard electrode potential values. Thank you, children.